愿主与你们同在，
也与你的心灵同在。
恭读圣马窦福音。
主愿光荣归于你。
那时候，耶稣对民众和他的门徒说：“经师和法利赛人坐在美色的座位上，他们所吩咐你们的，你们都要遵守，但不要效法他们的行为，因为他们只会说而不做。他们把承担而难以肩负的担子捆好，放在别人的肩上，自己连一个指头也不动。他们所做的一切都是为邻人注目，因此他们把经文的瞎子加大了，一岁加长了。他们喜爱筵席上的守卫，会堂中的上座，喜欢别人在街市上向他们挤至今，称他们为老师。至于你们，却不要被人称为老师，因为你们的老师只有一位。你们彼此都是弟兄，也不要称地上的人为父，因为你们的父只有一位，就是天父。你们也不要被人称为导师，因为你们的导师只有一位，就是摩西亚。你们中间最大的该做你们的仆役。自高自大的人必被贬义，自谦自卑的人必被高举。基督的福音。
基督，我们赞美你。
我们可能建造不到会会还有这个情况，我们有时候会听到那些长辈说：“我吃盐多过你吃米。”那个是我们可能常常听到的，但是我不是说对还是错，然后这个是我不是来做一个就是我不想说对还是错了，只是今天的福音告诉我们，不一定一个人不一定有能够说这句话的，因为我们每一个人有时候我们能够说，是做不到。今天耶稣为什么一直讲这些法利赛人还有经师？因为要提醒他们，他说的那句美色的座位，就是因为要提醒他们，你们要像美色一样。在就业当中，当他们从埃及出来的时候，还没有成为一个国家的时候，没有真正一个像政府一样的，所以没有什么法律，就是有美色一个人。所以他们社会有什么问题，有什么人要吵架等等，就是找美色。叫美色就是说 OK 好，你要这样做这样做这样做，就是美色的责任就是要把他们的自心处理好，而且要把他们更靠近天主。所以耶稣跟他们说，你们坐在美色的座位上的也要有这个责任。因为他们这个法利赛人，他们只是说你们该的做的就是这，就是法律上就是做这个做这做这，但是他们未必自己做到。美色他说的他也做得到，但是这些法利赛人呢，他们只是很厉害讲，但是他们不想做，就是讲罢了。而且他们是要人家看到他们很厉害，能够讲很多东西，能够教很多东西。其实外表是看很厉害，但是内向可能是很烂的，可能啊。对我们来说，现在的社会 也是一样的，我们每个人都有这个责任，不是单单说我比你厉害，而是我懂的东西比你多。我们应该说，我用我所了解的东西，把每个人更靠近，带他们更靠近天主。因为我们有时候我们讲东西的时候，我们可能有好的一个意思，我们要真的要帮一个人，但是我们讲的方法可能不太对，而且我们有时候讲的时候，那个人更加离远天主，因为我们没有真正去想，我们怎么讲天主的道理讲出来，或是天主的法力。当然，我们天主教很多东西可能不允许还是不能做，但是每一件都有它的理由的。如果我们就是单单说你听你跟，你不要问这样多，那谁要跟？我也不跟啊。至少你跟我你解释说，因为这样这样这样，所以我们才这样这样。至少我们更加了解。法利赛人的问题就是，他们只是说你们要应该做，不要问我为什么。我们不能这样，我们的责任就是后代，我们要教好。怎么样教呢？不一定是讲罢了，因为如果有智慧的人，真正有智慧的人，如果是智慧从天主来的，我们就会把自己的生活处理好先。我们讲的东西，我们活出一定要活出来，一定要配。因为如果我们一边讲一边做不一样的东西，那有什么意思？我看到我也说你这样的人，我也是不跟了，我不相信，因为你讲的东西跟你做的东西根本不配。所以耶稣就是警告群众还有他的门徒说，你们要尊重他们所说的话，因为他们教的东西是对的，但是你不要根据他们行为，因为他们行为是错的。我们每个人要问自己，当我们说一句话的时候，我们的行为配不配我们所说的东西？那个很重要。因为如果我们只是厉害讲话，还是厉害讲一些道理，还是懂很多东西，但是没有智慧，没有真正看自己到底我们讲的跟我们做的配不配，那也白白浪费了。所以我们要祈求天主给我们真正的智慧，圣神一直带领我们看看自己先，照照镜子看自己，到底我自己的生活跟我学到的或是我要教的东西配不配。如果不配，我怎么去处理好？So today we talk about the chair of Moses. I just want to focus on that because Jesus talks about the Pharisees and the scribes occupying the chair of Moses. Now, the chair of Moses is not exactly a physical chair, it's just an office of teaching. So he's reminding of them of the time when they were not a full nation yet. When they first came out of Egypt, they only had the Ten Commandments, but there was nothing else. So when society had problems, when the people had challenges, what did they do? They'll go to Moses and say, okay, now you know the law, tell us what to do. And so Moses, using this chair as his office, will try to settle everybody's problems. Now, why Jesus uses it because to remind them that the teaching office of Moses is not just about implementing the law, but it's about bringing people closer to God and also to understand why the law is there in the first place. He also lived the same life as the people. So whatever is applied in law to the people, he also applied it to himself. And this is why Moses is held in high regard in Israelite culture. Now, when you come to the time of Jesus, this was no longer the case. The scribes and Pharisees just like to show off their knowledge, to show that they know the law, but they never really explained to the people why. Because people at that time are not educated, so they just follow. But if you apply that to today, now all of us, or most of us, are educated. If I tell you one thing, the church says this, the tendency to first is to ask why. We never blindly follow anymore. Even for me, I'll ask why. And the answer cannot be because I say so. You cannot say good gifts can answer anymore. Or because I know better than you. No. Those answers are no longer valid. We, whoever is in the teaching authority of the church, that means us who are transmitting the faith down to the next generation, can be the priest, can be a sister, brother, can be those in Sunday school, we have the responsibility also of using the chair of Moses for the good of the people. To explain to them not only the laws of the church, but the laws of God and why it is important in our lives. The most important thing is to bring people closer to God, which is why we are reminded by Jesus not to follow the scribes and Pharisees, because they are clever at talking, but they are not good at doing. We should ask ourselves, are we doing the same? Are we only good at talking, but not good at doing? Because sometimes what we say and what we do does not match at all. And so we need to constantly look at ourselves, look in the mirror and ask ourselves, am I doing what I'm saying? Am I talking the talk? Am I acting out what I preach? And that is the most important. Whoever we are in whatever situation in life, whatever we say and do must match. Otherwise, we are just living like the scribes and Pharisees and like hypocrites. So we ask for the grace and guidance of the Holy Spirit to guide us in reflecting on our lives and to see whether it matches what the law teaches. If not, then we have to ask ourselves what happened and how we are to make it better.